Up next on CUTV, it's an all-new In Neon. Previously on In Neon.
You're engaged?
Almost, yeah.
Is that him?
Yeah.
So, do you want to get back with him?
Of course I do. What kind of stupid question is that?
Jen, listen. He's a player. He's bad news. When I woke up, I started thinking about life and I retired.
Before I go, though, I was wondering if I could have a few words with you in private to discuss your performance.
Her?
Me?
Her?
You unbelievable bastard. You're jealous.
You've always had a boyfriend. You cannot stand the thought of not having a boyfriend.
That's not true. Cleve and I did it last night.
What?
Jack thinks you kissed her, and Cindy said you attacked her.
Nothing happened. Absolutely nothing.
You've been treating me like a stranger for months.
No different than when you've been treating me.
You know, Cindy, this whole thing could go a lot easier if you'd learn to lighten up a little.
I was thinking maybe you and I could be study partners.
Study partners?
Only because you seem to be such a natural at it. I mean, you're such a brain at that stuff.
Stay away from the geek.
Look, Bobby, you're old news. If I want to have sex with Cleveland Grace, I will.
And now what you want is a passing grade in that class.
Whatever it takes.
Yeah, I saw a dozen roses in your bedroom.
Oh, those roses. Somebody gave those to me last week. Just a guy. Nothing special.
You know, Laura, I think it'd be a good idea for us not to see each other anymore.
But I love you.
What are you doing here?
You wouldn't understand! Just get out of here!
Laura, get off the damn tracks!
Oh, my whole life has been a nightmare! What do I do to correct it? I just screw it up even further!
Laura, get off the damn tracks!
Go, Jack! Just go!
Laura!
Get out of here, Jack! Go!
And now, the next exciting chapter of the college soap opera, In Neon.
What a rush, huh?
What the hell is wrong with you?
None of your damn business. I didn't ask for a knight in shining armor anyway. And flowers are still standing. Come on, Jack, what movie? Come on.
Are you suicidal now?
No, I'm sorry. It was Ghostbusters. 1984, Ivan Reitman, director.
Well, I think you've had enough.
Give me that.
No.
Give it back. Now that? That was inhumane.
Do you have the cartoon channel going on in your head?
More like the Adventure Channel, don't you think? I'll see you around.
Wait, you gonna go find a minefield or something?
Ooh! Now you're talking.
Why don't you just admit it?
I'll admit what, tough guy?
That you finally let someone get inside?
No one has gotten inside of me. Lately.
Real funny. Real funny, Laura.
Oh, Jack! Why can't you, huh? Why can't you? You know, you've got all this massive intelligence and everything, all this insight. Why don't you just turn it around on yourself, huh?
Stop it.
Well, maybe we're just both a couple of crazies.
Don't try to blame this on some kind of hard home
life. You have no idea how my life has
been. Oh, don't I? Beaten, pregnant at 15, abused, nobody cares. That's what you've told us, right? Or is it something else? Who's the guy at the cemetery? Who's David Levy? Who's David Levy?
How do you know that name?
Because I know, Laura.
How do you know David?
Your stepmother told me. I know about the flowers. I know about the trip to the cemetery. I know it was all a lie. You remember that psychology book you couldn't find? It just magically appeared back in your room? Your stepmother called. She told me that you left it back at her house during Christmas break. So I went there and I picked it up. And I put it back in your room.
You had no right.
I had every right. I'm your friend and I'm concerned about you. Just like your stepmother. Who turns out not to be a mean lady. How she gave me Christmas cookies on the way out the door.
You don't even know that happened.
Then tell me. Help me understand.
No, are you kidding? I'll be there. I just have to do something first. Cleveland Grace? Oh, that'll be the day. I just need to get a passing grade, and he's the one to do it. Hell no, we're not an item. Far from it.
Far from it.
You know, I just need to get my grades up, and whatever it takes. He's the one to do it. Are you kidding? Bobby? I have him wrapped around my finger just like Cleve. But let's get real. You know, as soon as I pass the final, I'm gonna dump Cleve and go back out with Bobby. I mean, he's the quarterback of the football team. A girl's gotta do what a girl's gotta do. You know how the game's played.
You know how I told you that I came from a broken home? That's not really true. Actually, I had a really great childhood. Some of the best years of my life. And when I told you that everyone abandoned me when I was 16, no. In fact, my stepmother still helps my dad finance my education. And about her being an alcoholic, you're right. She is a really decent person.
And what happened? What is it?
David was my boyfriend in high school. We were high school sweethearts. He was my first. I thought I was gonna marry him. You know how it is. I used to pray to God to please let him be the one. He lived about half an hour away from me on the outside of town, and he had a car. We were so in love then. And then, one night, Christmas Eve, we got into this fight. This stupid argument. He wanted to spend all of Christmas Eve with his family, and I wanted him to come over and see me. So I just laid into him with this guilt trip. And we got into this argument that escalated. Horrible, horrible, fine, ugly fight.
Fine, I hate you.
And then I hung up on him. I hung up. The argument was all my fault. I wanted him to, you know, to chase me, to play the game.
So what happened?
It snowed that night. A lot. And I just went to bed. And then, like 3 o'clock in the morning, the phone rang. I can still remember Dad coming into my room to wake me up. David had been in an accident. David's car went off the road and he was killed instantly. But it was my fault.
How was it your fault?
His brother said that he was coming over to apologize to me. To me. For an argument that I started. It was just a stupid, pointless. Do you know what they found in David's car? Christmas presents. Christmas presents. All addressed to me. He was coming over to apologize and give me Christmas presents that I yelled at him for. Nobody ever knew. They all thought I was Daddy's little princess. I guess I proved them wrong, huh? Look what I've become. That's why every year at Christmas time, I go to the cemetery to see. Because I never got a chance to say I was sorry. The last thing I ever said to him was that I hated him. Said was that I hated him.
That's why I couldn't tell you guys. That's why I never told anyone.
Laura, you can't live your life like this, carrying this load. You can't just close up like this.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. Maybe it just wasn't part of the universe's great plan.
Let me tell you something. I quit praying to the man upstairs a long time ago. I'm poisoned.
No, you're not. You're missing out too much on life. On Mark. It's not like when you and I were together. Or when you and the basketball team were together. Sorry. It's different. Do you know how many people wish they had what you and Mark have had these past few months? I mean, my God, you two just walk into a room and it lights up. You know what the best part is? You know what the best part of all of this is? You two were friends before you realized what was happening. You know, Laura, sometimes you don't have to understand everything that's happened. As long as we understand that it's happened for a reason.
I'm telling you, a flip would really wow them.
Yeah.
I'm serious.
Brett, I can't do a flip. It's everything I have in me not to...
What, are you nervous?
Brett, in case you haven't noticed, I'm not the most outgoing person in the world. Besides, if I had to do a flip, I'd land on my butt.
A former strip, exotic dancer. Who's shy? That's a new one. Why are you doing that?
What?
Counting.
I count to concentrate.
Concentrate.
I get really... I get really nervous.
Oh.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1.
So you count to stay from getting nervous?
No. I count to keep calm and to concentrate.
So at this rate, you're going to be like shouting at your audition. Listen, on game day, if you get nervous, just close your eyes, concentrate, and quit counting.
If I close my eyes, I'll end up on my butt.
No, you won't. Now, Jen, you told me that you're expecting a panel full of judges and your director. You just have to shut them out. That way you can feel the music.
You mean concentrate.
No. Feel the music. Be the music. Shake your booty.
Brett, when did you learn so much about music?
You have to feel it so you can understand it. That way you don't have to rehearse it. Right now, it looks like you're painting a fence. Okay, so spread your legs apart. Well, you said you were a stripper.
I was.
See, in order to be the music, you have to know how to dance to it. Right now, you're just moving from the waist up. You're doing the same thing now as what you did back then. You gotta move your hips. So, close your eyes right now. Close them.
I got out of the stripper business for a reason, Brett.
Jennifer, do you want my help or not? Now close your eyes. Now keep them closed. Keep them closed. All right. Now, move your hips. There you go. Loosen up. There you go. Loosen up. There you go. Should have done this from day one.
What? Grab my butt.
Don't be ridiculous. Nowhere near your butt.
Yes, you are.
Yes, I am. Now move your hips a bit. God, what'd you do your first night before you went on stage?
My first night?
You know, before you went to dance?
I closed my eyes.
You must have been hell on the pole. But Jen, if you count like that at your audition, the judges are going to see right past you. That's why you need to close your eyes and picture yourself naked. You need to feel the music when you're listening to it. Feel it. Be it. There's a lot of work involved. That's why you need to close your eyes. Feel it. Think of the first time when you're up there dancing. It'll all come rushing back. There you go. That's better. I used to think first, you have to have a good partner, which is me, of course. Then you have to just loosen up a bit. But now I know that life doesn't always go my way. Feel it. Yeah. Feels like I'm be it. That's when I there you go. That's better. Just loosen up a bit. You have to go more with your heart, less with your head. That's what you do if you get stage fright. If you do that, you haven't made it the auditions. I'm not a girl.
Not a test, I'm rapping to the beat. And me, the groove, and my friends are gonna try to move your feet. You see, I am Wonder Mike, and I like to say hello. Or to the black, to the white, the red, and the brown, and the purple, and yellow. But first, I gotta bang, bang, the boogie to the boogie. Say up, jump the boogie to the bang, bang, boogie. Let's rock. You don't stop, rock the rhythm, that'll make your body rock. Well, so far, you've heard my voice, but I brought two friends along. And next on the mic is my man Hank. Come on, Hank, sing that song. Check it out. I'm the CASN, the OVA, and
Thought we'd find you here.
I came here to think.
Yeah, I know.
Have you been crying?
I'm just not very good company right now.
What's wrong?
I just wish things would go back to the way they used to be. Everybody in the group hates each other. This is our senior year. We should be having the time of our lives. We should be happy and support each other. But you and Jack hate each other's guts. Mark and Laura aren't getting along. It's like we're all breaking up. I thought we'd be friends forever, you know? I always thought that no matter what happened between any of us, we'd come home and everything would be fine. On top of that, my professor wants to sleep with me or he won't let me graduate.
Look at this school. They haven't taken the Christmas decorations down yet.
What? Who?
Dr. Filosi. He's been coming on to me in class and in our private lessons.
Filosi?
Private lessons?
That old fart?
I was having problems in our class last semester, and he offered to tutor me. Now he's threatening my grades. If I don't get a good grade on the comprehensive, I won't graduate. I don't know what to do. I just know I can't prove it. And that's why I've been failing so many tests. Because I won't give in.
Well, I guess there's only one thing you can do.
Punt?
No. We'll help you.
Yeah. Help me? Somebody
once told me the I took the class last semester. Saved all my notes.
And I have a class this semester. She was looking kind of dumb
with her finger and her thumb in the shape. We'll help you study. We'll help you graduate. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. And they say it gets colder. You're bundled up now, wait till you get older. But the media men beg to differ, judging by the hole in the satellite picture. The ice we skate is getting pretty thin. The water's getting warm, so you might as well swim. My world's on fire, how about yours? That's the way I like it and I'll never get bored. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play.
Brings you to this neck of the woods.
So this is where your second home is.
Yeah, I'm just working on a video for the group. Come on in. Watch this. This is from the Christmas party 2 years ago. Brett got all drunked up and was hitting on that cheerleader, Samantha.
Yeah?
And he tried to tell her that he was studying thoracic medicine.
Oh yeah, and he got so drunk that he said Jurassic medicine and he spilled his drink all over her.
Oh, that was great.
You got that on tape?
Yeah, check it out.
So why are you doing all this anyway?
Well, I'm putting, like, all of the video, like, the greatest hits of our group, into a collaborative video for my senior project. You know, the one I've been talking about so much?
Oh, that's great. So then we'll have something to look back on.
Right. So, Senator, is that you all drunked up with the college co-ed?
Cleve, thanks for helping me out.
No problem.
About what happened?
Listen, just forget it.
I can't forget about it. You must have thought I was pretty bad when I said things were your fault last semester.
Well, I mean, the thought did cross my mind, considering nothing happened.
So why didn't you ever say anything?
And what? Ruin a perfectly good lie?
I guess I deserved that.
Yeah, you did. Look, I never said anything because I thought deep down that someday you would.
I was just confused, Cleve. I hadn't been with anybody but Jack for a long time. I wanted him back. I wanted to make him jealous.
By telling Mark that I raped you?
I didn't say that. I said I... I'm sorry.
You have to tell the truth, Cindy. For Mark and whoever else knows.
No one else knows.
And Jack and you and Mark knows too.
How can I make it up to you?
I don't know, Cindy. I mean, I guess you're just gonna have to take some time, you know? And maybe the truth?
Wait for my cue and just listen. Play my position like a show star. Pick up everything, mommy, hitting it in no time.
with him, and that's for sure. Cause I never been the type to break up a happy home. But it's something about baby girl, I just can't leave alone. So tell me, mom, what's it gonna be? She said,
you don't know what you mean to
come
me.
On.
Were you a stripper or something? You were a stripper?
It got me through my first couple years of college.
You!
Is that so hard to believe? Believe.
You have to go more with your heart, less with your head.
You're doing the same thing now as what you did back then. I thought you said you were a stripper.
I was. Hey, is this thing on?
Hey!
Am I interrupting?
No, I was just studying.
What's up?
Why did you buy me those roses?
I just wanted to see how things panned out.
Brett, I didn't. I mean, I've been thinking. I want you to be there.
Be where?
At my audition.
I don't know.
But it's like, you're my good luck charm, Brett. I need you to be there.
I just don't think it'd be a good idea.
Brett, I'm really nervous. Really, really nervous. I need you to be there. I need you to keep me calm.
Calm?
Brett, you make me unnervous. All I have to do is look at your smiling face and I'm not nervous anymore. It's like the little things, you know? Like when you tell me to close my eyes and concentrate, I do. And everything is so clear.
I don't know, Jen. It's just... Jen, you don't need me. You'll be great.
But the music, the routine, the dance, that's all your idea.
Yeah, but you're the one that's gonna be at the audition. You're the one trying out. I mean, don't worry about it, because you're gonna walk in there and they're gonna be like, ooh, and you're gonna be like, yeah. And then when you get up there and you do your thing, you know, they're gonna be like, wow. And then you'd be like, yeah. And they'll be like, that sounds gonna go. You don't need me.
But Brett, it's those little things that you come remind me of. I need my coach.
Okay.
Really?
Yeah, what the hell?
This means a lot. Thanks, Brett. Jen! Tom's here!
Better go get that.
Jen!
Thanks.
The look of my good woman is when the summon you're interested in is walking out, you know, like you're leaving. And at the last possible instant, they turn around and look at you one more time. And then they're on their merry way.
sunglasses.
Yeah.
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 Oh,
Jeez.
Yeah, let me use your phone.
No.
Crazy.
But I'm waiting for this guy. Is anybody else hungry? Are you hungry?
I'm hungry.
Are you guys hungry?
Oh,
hey, Mark, how
are
you feeling today?
Oh, fine.
He laid his beer down, and I didn't know it was his, and I got a cigarette butt, and I threw it in there, and he chugged it. He drank the whole thing.
Okay. I got so sick.
Who are my sunglasses?
Oh, they're cool. Thanks.
No, Brett, I'll wait for this guy to go.
Hey, you guys want some peanuts over there?
Brett, you didn't even pay the
okay. It was horrible.
Floating in your stomach.
No,
I'm waiting for this guy.
I want to order a pizza. I want to order a pizza. I want anybody to know when I was in the
kitchen. Please, get out of here.
Here we are with Brett Tierney. Brett, do you have anything to say about this documentary of our lives?
Yes, remember Brett's motto, never date within the group. Get off. Let me see your phone. Come on. Never tell the story when I was in the cafeteria.
Her talent is beyond her years. She is definitely one to watch. A promising newcomer on the horizon.
What does that mean?
He wants to take the entire entourage, fly them out to London, and work with Her Majesty's Royal Theater.
So, will we be leaving the country for a while, or?
A while? Ha! How about for good? 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 Think about it, Kim. Your name. Neon lights. Neon lights. Neon lights. Neon lights. By the way, you do know who got her start at Her Majesty's Theater, don't you? Sarah Brightman? You do know who Sarah Brightman is, don't you?
Of course. Sarah Brightman had the lead role in Phantom of the Opera. She played Christine. The whole production was born at Her Majesty's Theater in London.
That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right.
Sharpens, heightens each sensation. Darkness wakes and stirs imagination. Silently the senses abandon their defenses, helpless to resist the notes I write. For I compose the music of the night. Slowly, gently, night unfurls its splendor. Grasp it, sense it, tremulous and tender. Hearing is believing, music deceiving, hard as lightning, soft as candlelight. Dare you trust the music of the night? Close your eyes, for your eyes will only tell the truth, and the truth isn't what you want to see. In the dark, it is easy to pretend that the truth is what it ought to be. Softly, deftly, music shall caress. Feel it secretly possess you. Open up your mind, let your fantasies unwind in this darkness which you know you cannot fight. The darkness of the music of the night. Close your eyes, start a journey through a strange new world. Leave all thoughts of the world you knew before. Close your eyes and let music set you free. Only then can you
thank you.
Hello. No, this is Brett. Jack, who's calling? Oh, Booth. I don't see him around. Hold on, kill him for a second, I have a call. Hello. Yeah, this is me. Nah, sorry, man. No, I don't do that anymore. I'm out of it. Ackerman? Really? How much money did you say? Yeah, give me a second. Let me go upstairs. Almost there. Whew. Yeah, go ahead. How much money are we talking about? And Ackerman's involved. That's a pretty big package. What time tomorrow? Yeah, maybe I can help you. Sure, yeah. Okay, but this is the last time. All right, bye.
Business?
No, I was, classes. Scheduling class stuff. What'd you do last night?
Long story. Have any phone calls?
Phone calls. Oh, phone calls. Hello? Hey. Sorry, Booth called from the Big Apple.
What'd he say?
Well, I had another call.
You said he had another call?
No, I had another call.
That's it?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Tell me you didn't hang up on him.
Maybe he'll call back.
Please spread the word. I'm waiting for his phone call. It's important.
You got it. Doomer? Yeah, it's Brett. Listen, I need you for one more job. Yeah, we're back in business one last time.
Lipstick and lashes, the traces of stardom, lit up on a billboard so everyone sees them in neon. Behind the counter, she stares out the window, up at the billboard that's like a reminder in neon. She hates how she feels, but she hangs like a mirror. Maybe a stranger could walk in and see her in neon. For 2 cents of danger, she trusts anybody. She'd smoke like a gun if it meant she might wind up in neon. The dreams and the light of a promise that dies, a shimmering city, a glimmer of a hope and a lie. In neon, the name's gone, there's no reason why anymore. Trust them and wind up alone behind a locked door.
I wanted to know, have you made your decision yet?
A glimmer of a hope and a lie. In neon.
There have been many moments of uncertainty. Numerous instances of both peril and danger. Some cliffhangers that have been resolved, and some that have not. But next time on an all-new In Neon, an act of anger boils over and will cost someone their life. Don't miss the next chapter of the college soap opera, In Neon.
this year when you're in a rubber dub style. And this year when you say the well versatile. Everywhere me come, me say the people them a smile. Because me grow up as a disciplined child. Open me mind, open me heart. Come into me brain and make me breathe faster. All I know is you are mine. I mean, know me, I go love you till the end of time.